I'm Peggy Scott Laborde, and welcome to Steppin Out, spotlighting the New Orleans area's arts and entertainment scene. Seated at our table tonight, Poppy Tooker, host of the WWNO radio program, Louisiana Eats. Hey, Miss Poppy.
Hey, Peg.
Good to see you. And we are so thrilled, actors Troy Poplous and Janet Shea, here to discuss their upcoming roles in Katrina, Mother-in-Law of them all, at the Joy Theater August 28th and 29th. Good to see you all. Hello.
Thank you for having us.
Absolutely. And Alan Smason will return next week with a Broadway preview. But first up, Poppy.
Well, don't you love in New Orleans how we have these restaurant dynasties? You know, the Brennans, the family goes into the, but if you're gonna have a restaurant, it's a family affair anyway. If you wanna see mom and dad, you better go to the restaurant and work there.
Exactly.
Well, last Friday night, I had the opportunity after we finished here to dine at Cafe Giovanni. And it was really the place to be last Friday night. Even Eric Paulson and his lovely wife were there dining. And I got to see Chef Duke LeCicero, and he was just tickled to death and brought out of the kitchen so proudly his son, Nick.
Oh.
And Nick is just 20 years old. Apparently, he graduated from high school and went straight to the Culinary Institute of America.
Wow.
He's freshly graduated and home in the kitchen with Dad. And so, isn't that charming?
Yeah.
And we had a lot of delicious things to eat. And I have to say, guilty as charged, I had the Oysters Giovanni for the first time. It's such a beautiful dish. Those are fried oysters on sort of a stained glass presentation of five different sauces. Mm. It was yummy. Mm. And the opera, you know, it's lots of fun. And then, I don't know if you've had a chance yet to go to Compère Le Pain.
I have not.
Well, it's a really beautiful restaurant, and it's in that old 77 Chandlery and Hotel that's right there on Chapitoulas. And one of the big draws about Compère Le Pain is if you are a Top Chef fan, as so many people are, one of the alumni from Top Chef, Nina Compton, is the chef there. And they've been open a very short time, just a couple of months. Well, she's doing something really special next Sunday on August the 9th. She's hosting what's sort of a Top Chef reunion dinner, and at the same time, it's also a four-course seafood celebration of two coasts, paired with Oregon wines, because who is coming in to cook these dinners with her are Vitaly Paley, who is a very big deal Portland chef, and he's got the Portland Penny Diner in Portland, Oregon. He, in 2005, won the James Beard Award for Best Chef of the Northwest, and people may also be familiar with him from Food Network, because he was a winner of Iron Chef. So, he's a big deal, and coming along with him is Doug Adams. He has a restaurant also in Portland called Imperial, and just like Nina Compton, Adams is also a Top Chef alum. He actually won third place last season. So this is gonna be a delicious opportunity to eat that incredible Pacific Coast
and this is right
seafood.
Off Poydras, huh?
Not on Chapitoulas. It's right there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we don't get a lot of Pacific seafood here much, you know? So Nina's going to be cooking Louisiana seafood. They're going to be cooking West Coast seafood, and it's going to be really delicious. I hope there's some Kumamoto oysters. Those are one of my favorite things. And then tomorrow, big exciting day. Every year we have culinary, and it is the best bargain all year long. It kicks off tomorrow. There's 70 participating restaurants, and something that they've added new this year is brunch. So there are a multitude of places to go for brunch for $39 or less. You can go to Restaurant Revolution, Tableau, Antoine's, Commander's. Yeah, for $39 or less. Muriel's, La Provence, those are some of the brunch locations. And, you know, I just have to say that also included, there's so many fine restaurants, Brightston's, G.W. Finn's, Le Ferret, Carrollton Market, The Grill Room. It's a month-long opportunity to try new restaurants and splurge on really fine dining that maybe you wouldn't do ordinarily. So take advantage of the bargains. Go to culinary.com to find the full list of who's participating in culinary this year.
Sounds good. Poppy, we didn't really have a chance to talk about the Tales of the Cocktail and your experiences at Tales. I know you did a lot of interviews for your radio show, but coming out of it, it seemed like the usual bigger and better than ever before.
I'll tell you the truth, Peg. It was like Mardi Gras Day in the lobby at the Monteleone Hotel. I mean, you could barely get through the lobby. The crowd was enormous this year, and I really had some great fun. Three nights in a row, I got invited to go to spirited dinners, and I had, oh gosh, I had a divine rum dinner at Restaurant Revolution. I got to sit next to my chum, T. Martin, at Commander's with the Maker's Mark folks, and then, oh my goodness, Tres Agaves tequila, which is really something, at Johnny Sanchez with Aaron Sanchez there.
Oh,
it was really fun. So Poppy worked very hard in the daytime and she played very hard at night.
And you know, a lot of people, and it's great because during the summer it's typically fairly slow in New Orleans and we need our visitors, but it was a mix of locals too. I know a lot of locals who went as well.
You know what surprised me was, you know, I hosted those two butchers' breakfasts at Toujac's, as if I needed another job during Tales of the Cocktail. The people who came, a lot of them were our listeners, and it was more locals, I think, than there were out-of-town Tales people.
I like the mix, and some people actually stay downtown, and you know, so
well,
that
I do,
sense.
But that's because they keep me chained to a microphone.
Okay, but it's still a smart thing, especially if you're imbibing, right?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. It's so much fun, and pedicabs.
If you
haven't done that, get in a pedicab. Well, you've seen me in a pedicab before.
Your entourage.
I always feel like I'm in a parade.
Yes, your instant parade. Yeah. Thank you, Poppy.
Thanks, Ben.
And New Orleans Magazine's quiz queen, Julia Street, has a question for us. Last time, Rebecca Siskin gave us the titles of one of Louis Armstrong's songs that was used as a Robin Williams movie in it, and another that was taken from a Broadway musical. It's a Wonderful World from Good Morning Vietnam and Hello Dolly, of course. Now tonight's question. We're still in the Louis Armstrong mode because of Satchmo Fest. Among the Louis Armstrong recordings, one was named after a carnival crew, another after an area on the lakefront. What are they? Email your answers to steppinout@wyes.org. Our prizes, a year's subscription to Louisiana Life magazine, a gift certificate for two, courtesy of Vianne's Tea House in Old Mandeville, offering their culinary and gourmet tea experience. And tonight, we have two kitchen towels with the messages, Girls Gone Chihuahua, and It's Schnauzer or Never, from our friends at wearablevegetables.com. And you can visit WYES.org for our online calendar to see our lineup of events. And you can also link to our WYES YouTube channel to visit our program on our homepage. And now I am really thrilled. I get to talk to Janet and Troy. And we'll talk about the show first.
Let's
but then I
talk
want to talk about
it.
You mm-hmm. all. But Katrina, mother-in-law of them all. Okay, can't help but think about Ernie Cato when you talk about
it
mother-in-law.
It takes place in the mother-in-law lounge.
Yeah. This is Rob Florence.
Rob
Florence
put together this after interviewing many, many people and their Katrina experiences. And this is kind of a history, this show, because it started out as a few years ago as monologues. And then the cast got smaller. He did some experimenting with it in New York and in California, Los Angeles, then came back here, and now we have six characters, and we're all talking together.
Now, is this a comedy, drama? What do we expect?
It's a little bit of everything. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because each one of these people who had to evacuate had some experiences that were frightening and some that were really funny.
And this is set in the mother-in-law lounge.
Oh,
Ernie Cato's mother-in-law lounge.
Ernie Cato's mother-in-law lounge, right.
Okay. Troy, who do you play?
I play Raymond. And, you know, as all New Orleanians, we have a flair for storytelling. So those serious moments, they pan out with some humor.
Now, some people are actually playing themselves. I understand the photographer and Haunted
Sydney
History
Smith
Tour.
Smith is
guy.
Playing
Sydney
himself
Smith.
And his evacuation with, I think, a lady from Cuba.
Yeah.
and actually criminal.
Okay. Well, there are stories to tell, and the fact is that everybody who lived in New Orleans at that time, from New Orleans, the stories are incredible. We all have our stories.
We all do. Yeah.
So Rob is kind of putting this together.
The lady I play is a very interesting lady. I met her and talked to her. She's an uptown lady who refused to leave her house when her son wanted her to. So she ends up by herself in her neighborhood, and she evacuates with some kids who just are all tattooed and body pierced, and they save her.
Now, Jonathan Merez, I understand, is producing, and it's going to be at the Joy.
This at the Joy Theater.
August 28th and 29th is a little bit, you have a little bit of time, and call now for reservations. But that should be fun, playing the Joy.
Yes, yes, it is playing fun playing the Joy. A bigger audience, I think, than we've ever had. Mm-hmm.
And you said the dressing rooms are in a unique place?
They are, yeah, the dressing rooms, I worked there before. The dressing rooms are in the basement.
In New Orleans, there aren't too many real basements.
No, the dressing rooms are very nice, but they are down in the basement. Uh-huh. And well, at the Beverly, the dressing rooms were down. Do you remember that?
Yeah, that's right. I'd forgotten about that.
Right.
The word basement is not... It means the first floor of a two-story house.
Maybe there's a nicer way of putting it, but anyway. So there's six of us. Troy Bechet. We have two Troys in this. Troy Bechet is playing...
Who's a woman, in case people don't realize
Antoinette.
That.
Wonderful.
Was also a great singer, too.
Yes, she is.
Yes.
Zeb Hollins III.
Yes.
And Sidney Smith is playing himself, and Randy Rasmussen is playing himself.
Oh, wow.
So,
well, I know that, as we said, Rob's been working on this for a long time, and Rob himself is interesting because I've known him for many years. He was a Park Service Ranger at one point. He's a longtime playwright. I've seen him on stage as an actor. Mm-hmm. So he's pulling together these various talents for this, too.
I was on stage with Rob at the very beginning, I'm trying to think. It was a Tennessee Williams play.
Oh, Sweet Bird of Youth.
Sweet Bird of Youth. Right, that was his first
Tennessee
play,
Tennessee Williams Festival, So, bravo to him. Now, we both know, once again, March 28th and 29th, and you can check that out on
August
the website.
August 28th.
Excuse me, now, March. I'm thinking Tennessee Williams.
August.
I love it.
August 28th and 29th.
August 28th and 29th.
And we have a show on Friday. We have a Saturday matinee and a Saturday night.
Yeah.
So if you could go to thejoy.com, all the information is there.
Well, very good. Well, let's talk about you all.
Okay.
And it was a great joy to see you a few months back. And Driving Miss Daisy, that's got to be one of your favorite roles.
It is.
At Bayou Playhouse.
Wonderful. At Bayou. And I also did it for Dennis at J-Pass. Uh-huh.
Well, there you are. And that's a cast, huh? With Lance.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness. And Spud. But that's also a tour de force because you're on most of the time. I mean, you're on stage. That's quite the role.
It's a huge role, and it just travels all over the place emotionally, you know. But it was so much fun to work with those two guys.
I bet. Now, I know that you, in addition to wearing your acting hat, both of you are longtime teachers.
Right.
And you are now retired, but from New Orleans School of Creative Arts, NOCA.
That's right, NOCA. I was there 21 years.
Wow. Oh, wow. And you've been performing, and dare I say, since the 1950s?
This is my 60th year.
Wonderful.
Oh, right.
And Troy, you teach, and you're still teaching at McDonough 35.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And also at Dillard.
Working at Dillard University too. In their theater department with Ray Verzel and Corthell Clark.
Wonderful. And you went to Loyola, didn't
you? Yes.
And you also sang. You're with the Opera Association from time to time.
Yes.
I saw a great photo of you and Aida. That had to be a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah. It was a great time. Great music. Great cast of singers, and I also did Aida at Le Petit, and played the role of Amanasra at Le Petit.
And the last time you were on, of course, you were here for Hair, because you directed Hair.
Yes, yes.
So what are you up to these days in addition to this? Are you going to be directing anytime soon?
I just closed the show.
Something,
Riding Haley's Comet at Mid-City theater.
Yes, and we have to stop for a moment and sniff, sniff on that.
Yeah.
Mid-City Theater just closed this week. We're very sorry to hear that. That's
so
going to be
sudden.
A huge gap. Yeah. And Fred Nuccio and Sue Gonzi, so wonderful.
And Sue Gonzi, oh my goodness.
But also, it was just a very comfortable space.
Very comfortable space.
And open to having anybody who wanted
to go in, and you always felt like you had friends there.
Yeah.
You felt very safe there.
Absolutely. You could park. And we're still missing the Chat Noir. Now we're going to be missing Mid-City. And Sue is such a staple at both places, you know. But are you going to be directing in the fall with school?
Yes, hopefully. Well, we're moving into a new facility this year, McDonough 35, a brand new facility, which is state of the art. And it's a monstrous building compared to the schools that we have here in our city. I have a new black box theater.
Now where's this going to be?
It's on the bayou, right off of St. Bernard near the Carrollton Park, Columbia Park area. Which is between Harrison and...
It's close to Harrison, bridge right there.
Yes.
That's going to be an enormous facility.
Yes, it is.
I'm always amazed, like, for instance, Hines School is huge.
Yes.
And so this is another one of those. What a great opportunity for the kids, huh?
Yeah, it's going to be a great opportunity for me to get in there and...
to have your own theater?
Oh, yes.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
That'll be nice.
Yeah, it's going to be a great thing for me. 35, spent 43 years in its current location, and this is huge for all of the students at the school.
Kind of waxing nostalgic, though.
Because I'm a graduate of MAC 35, and so.
What will happen to the building? Do they know yet?
Right now, the talk is about it becoming a transitional space for schools that are being renovated. They will use the space and then move on to their locations. Things change, but that's
right,
what's
we'll
in
see. We'll
yeah,
see.
Yeah.
Well, Janet, both of you all wearing your teacher's hat, if our viewers are interested in becoming an actor or actress, what do you tell them? What can they do?
First of all, I think you have to really build your confidence. And I think you have to study and read.
Go to plays.
I think you need to see live plays.
Yes,
I
certainly.
Really do, because a lot of times kids see a lot of TV and they say, oh, I can do that. But when you put yourself out on a stage, it's something really different.
Yeah.
But they need to learn how to move.
Yeah.
They need to learn how to speak well. And they need to really know how to analyze. So it's training.
Yes.
Training.
Just a quick memory as a teenager being in a play that was Rapunzel at Gallery Circle Theater, directed by George Patterson, and then later directed Le Petit by Louis Barroso. But I'll never forget that there was one of my fellow actors who just kept dropping lines, and that can happen to anybody. And George turned to us with the most simplest of direction and said, concentrate. And for some reason that has stuck with me.
That's
something so simple but not easy to do when you have distractions, if somebody's coughing in the audience or whatever, or giggling or talking, or on these days Patti LuPone and the cell phone or another in the middle of a Broadway show. She stopped and grabbed this person's cell phone. She was so tired of the person texting on a cell phone. But concentrate. I mean,
concentrate.
That's amazes me.
Stella Adler used to tell her students to listen with their blood.
Yes.
Isn't that great?
Yes.
Oh, I love that. But and I know there are, during the summer, of course, there are theater camps. But just if you're in high school, just be in a play. If you're not lucky enough to be in NOCA or wherever, get into
your theater club or be in a play or something like that. And your choir.
Yes.
All of those things, because choir develops your voice.
Yes.
And you become, you have poise.
Right.
You mm-hmm. you can become comfortable in front of people.
Right.
And I think that helps you in anything that you do.
It does.
Yeah.
And dance classes, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, good advice. Once again, looking forward to August 28th and
29th. August
28th
and 29th.
Katrina, yeah. mother-in-law of them
thank
all.
You for
looking forward
us.
To seeing it. Thank
yes,
you all
thank
so
you.
Much.
Thank you, Peggy.
And you know, if you're looking for a family-friendly place to cool off this summer, Kelsi Schreiber takes us to a place where leisure and learning are combined.
Where can you and your family go to learn about the Mississippi, New Orleans architecture, and make groceries all under one roof?
Formerly a warehouse, it's now the Louisiana Children's Museum.
We'll give you a whirlwind tour of one of the city's most beloved family destinations. It's perfect for staycationing.
The Louisiana Children's Museum opened in 1986, and actually originally in this building. We were in a small portion upstairs, but we've always been on Julia Street. The museum's exhibits are all planned really with the parents in mind as well as the children, so that the everyday moments of the museum can be used for learning, for exploration, for language development, for school readiness. There's so much content here, but it's all baked together in fun. Lots of hands-on fun. You know, there are lots of favorites, but I think the one that rises to the top of the list is the grocery exhibit. Everyone loves the Little Winn-Dixie grocery exhibit, so that's a very special one. Then we have an exhibit called New Orleans Proud to Call It Home, and it is 300 years of history of New Orleans, but starts with urban planning, city planning, the original plan of the French Quarter, architectural design and construction, and it's a very open-ended experience. We want to reflect our community, and of course, none of us would be here without the Mississippi River and the Port of New Orleans. So we have the Little New Orleans Port. It's a great example to learn about the global importance of the Port of New Orleans and to understand how we're connected to other countries and other continents through the busy port and the Mississippi River. The museum is really the primary resource in the state of Louisiana that's developed specifically for young children and their families and open to the public. And we connect play and learning in everything we do, in every exhibit, every space. Children come here and they love to play. They love to create, they love to build and imagine and role play. They'll step into new roles. But it's a great combination of play and learning coming together in one place, under one roof, that's always air conditioned and always dry. A good place for the summer.
I like coming to the museum because you can be with your family and friends and you can have a good time because there's a lot that you can do here.
But that's just one opinion. Don't take our word for it. Come see for yourself.
And thanks so much to Kelsi, Larry Russeri, and Steve Golombieski for their fine work on that piece. And admission to the Louisiana Children's Museum is just $8.50 for adults and children. And tomorrow, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., children can learn basic financial skills as they earn pretend money at exhibit areas throughout the museum. And throughout the month of August, the Louisiana Children's Museum will be featuring a new exhibit entitled Katrina Voices, a Storytelling Project. The museum will be free on Saturday, August 29th, and Sunday, August 30th, because of Katrina, and visit the website at lcm.org. And now it's time for our weekly artist spotlight. Tonight we're featuring two works of art. The first is titled Transcendence by Casey Parkinson. A Hammond native, Parkinson earned her MFA from Louisiana Tech University after completing a year's apprenticeship at Pozzolot, and that's in New Orleans, of course. She uses her clay skills to create functional wares, sculpture, and installation art. The second piece of art is titled Exploitation. That's by Carly Exfoliation, rather, by Carly Trosclair. She's a native New Orleanian. Trosclair earned her BFA from Loyola University. Her installations illustrate the transformations that a building may experience in its lifespan. Both artists are included in the group exhibit Reverb, Past, Present, and Future, which opens with a reception that's tomorrow evening at the Contemporary Arts Center, and that's, of course, on Camp Street. The openings are held in conjunction with White Linen Night, with opening receptions along Julia Street in the Arts District tomorrow. By the way, Arthur Roger Gallery will highlight several artists, Whitfall Lovell, the late Gordon Parks, Willie Birch, and Bruce Davenport, Jr., while Lemieux Galleries features Catherine Hunter, just to mention a few. And look out for all of those. And also, we wanted to tell you that over at Rhino Gallery in Canal Place, check out artist blacksmith Rachel David's new show. That's opening tomorrow. Details on a reception for the artists next week. And now it's time for our picks. Troy.
Over the river and through the woods. Peter Gabb, who's a great
friend of ours.
Yeah.
And too.
Yes. Everybody's down. Yeah.
And it's at St. Philip Neri School.
Oh, how fun. Yeah. That'll be fun. Yeah.
Next weekend is a big weekend for foodies in New Orleans. It's going to kick off Friday night at the Convention Center with the Chef's Challenge. And it's going to be 10 chefs from all across the country competing, judged by chefs and judged by attendees. And then that's part of that whole weekend of events. It's an international conference. It goes through Monday. And there's a great deal on discount for tickets right now. So
okay,
if you want to go, get that discount.
Good deal. Good. Janet.
I'm going to do two.
Okay,
Hello,
sure.
Hello Dolly at Tulane Summer Lyric. And my friend Margot Fanning is starring in The Book of Liz at the new theater on St. Claude, Jimmy Fitzmaurice's new place.
All right, great, so. Thank you. And now my picks. New Orleans Museum Month kicks off tomorrow and continues through the month of August. Members of participating museums receive free admission for two for any participating museum. So become a member and then you can enjoy free admission all month long for you and a friend. Visit touristathome.com to see a full list of those museums. Satchmo Summerfest continues, that's through the weekend, of course, and visit FQFI.org/Satchmo for a full lineup of events. Clarinist Tim Laughlin and trumpeter Connie Jones performs at noon on Sunday at the Mint. You can also visit Tim's website to see his performance schedule. He's a busy guy. Congratulations to writer Alex Kershaw for the launch of his new book, Avenue of Spies, a true story of terror, espionage, and one American family's historic resistance in Nazi-occupied Paris. The book launch and signing will take place at the National World War II Museum, and of course that is next Tuesday, August 4th at 6 p.m. Call 528-1944 extension 412 to reserve your seat, and you can visit Kershaw's website to learn more about him. It's amazing how many books that he has written, wow. And it's really a great opportunity to meet him and sign your own book. Thank you all so much. It was great to have
Thanks.
You all.
You
Thanks for watching. Mm-hmm. Good night.